What if I could show you how to clear all the numbers in Excel instantly without touching a single formula or text label? Most people do this the hard way, clicking and deleting numbers one by one, turning a 5-second job into a 5-minute headache. But today, I'm sharing two lightning-fast methods that will change how you tackle this challenge in Excel. I'm Victor, and after helping thousands of people master Excel, I can tell you that this first method is a real eye-opener. Here's the situation. I've got this spreadsheet with income and expense data. I want to clear all these numbers, but keep my text labels and formulas completely untouched. First, I'll select the range I want to clear. Then I'm going to press Ctrl G to open the Go To dialog. Now here's the magic part. I'm going to click on Special. This opens up a special menu that most Excel users have never seen. I want to select Constants and then deselect Text, Logicals, and Errors. Now this tells Excel exactly what we want. Find me only the cells with actual numbers and ignore the text and other formulas. We just want the raw numbers. Now when I click OK, boom, look at that. Excel's just selected every single number in the range, but notice that the labels like wages, interest, and miscellaneous aren't highlighted, and neither are the total formulas. Now I just hit delete and all the numbers are gone, but my structure is completely intact. The labels are still there and the formulas are showing dashes because there's just no data to calculate. So to recap this method, select, press Ctrl G, Special, Constants, and then remove text, logicals, and errors, and click OK. Then hit delete. Done in less than 10 seconds. But what if you do this every single day? Let me show you how to create a custom button that does this with literally one click, so you don't have to go through all those steps. First, I'm going to restore my data so you can see this in action. I'll press Ctrl Z and Ctrl Z. Now here's where Excel gets really fun. I'm going to create a custom button here that does everything we just did, but instantly. I'll go to Insert, then click on Illustrations and Shapes, then I'll choose a rounded rectangle, and I'll draw it right here, and add the text, Quick Clear. So I'm going to format it and align it center and middle. Now comes the crucial part. I'll right-click on the button and select Assign Macro. Excel opens up the Assign Macro dialog box. And in this context, a macro is just a set of instructions that tells Excel what to do. So I'm going to select Quick Clear. This is a macro I saved earlier. Then click OK. Now all I need to do is select the data range. Then watch this. When I click Quick Clear, every single number vanishes, but all the headers and formulas are still perfectly preserved. So clicking on that button will run the macro that we just assigned. And here's a pro tip. When you use macros like this, always save your workbook as macro enabled so you don't lose the functionality. So go to File, Save As, and make sure you check this option, Excel Macro Enabled Workbook, and give it a name here. One quick warning though, the Quick Clear macro has no undo, so make sure you're ready to clear that data and always keep a backup of anything important. Now I could just give you the macro code to copy and paste, and you can definitely get it from the downloadable workbook. Just check the description below for that. But here's why I'm not stopping there. If you just copy and paste the code without understanding it, you're missing the real goldmine. Because once you see how this actually works under the hood, you'll realize that VBA isn't some scary programming language. It's almost like having a conversation with Excel in plain English. And that opens up a whole new world where you can make Excel do much more than you thought possible. Let me show you what I mean. First, I'm going to open the VBA editor by pressing Alt and F11. Now VBA is the programming language for Excel macros. It stands for Visual Basic for Applications. Let me walk you through this VBA code here, like we're detectives solving a mystery. So the code itself is stored in this module here called Module 1. We can choose more descriptive names and change the name here, but for now I'll stick with Module 1 to keep it simple. So the first line is sub, quick clear, open and close parentheses. This gives our automation a name. It's like adding a new word to Excel's dictionary. Next we have dim my range as range and dim cell range as range. Now here we're setting up two variables called my range and cell range for selected range. So think of them as labels on empty boxes ready to store the locations of the cells that we're going to use later on in the code. And here's where it gets interesting. Application.screenUpdating equals false. Now this turns off Excel's visual updates. It's like turning off notifications while you work. So Excel finishes the job faster because it isn't pausing to show you every step. Now, the clever part, we set cell range equals intersect selection comma activesheet.useRange. So this finds the overlap, the intersect, between what you selected and what actually has data on the active sheet. So active sheets.used range. It's like saying only look at the useful stuff. So if nothing is selected, then we'll jump to this exit label, which is actually down here. And all that does is it turns screen updating for the application back on, and then it cleanly exits the subroutine. So that word SUB stands for subroutine or subprocedure. We started the subroutine up here and we're ending it down here. So if nothing was selected, we do this bit. But if the user did select something, then the action begins. This thing here is called a loop. For each myRange in cell range, we're telling Excel to visit every single cell called myRange in our selection cell range, which we set up here. So cell range is the intersection of selection and the active sheet's use range. And this next line here, if isNumeric myRange.formula is true, sounds like a mouthful. But what that means is for each cells.formula, we ask, are you a number? So if you're a number and that's true, then we can proceed to clear it. But if it's not, then we'll leave it and go to the next cell in this for each loop. So before we move on, let me explain this dot merge area. It means we're clearing all the cells that are merged with the cell myRange that we're checking. So if one goes, they all go. And this clear contents is the command that clears the cell or the merged area. So this protect contents bit, this protection bit, might seem a bit tricky, but all it's doing is making sure we don't try to make changes if the cell is locked. So we only make changes if it's false. So protect contents is false. If we try to make changes when it's protected, that would result in an error. So here's the full logic in plain English. If the current cell called myRange has a formula that's a number, and if that sheet is not protected, then we'll clear the cell and any merged area immediately because there's no restrictions to stop us. Else, if the sheet is protected, then we only clear the cell and any merged area if that cell is not locked. And these next few lines wrap up each conditional check, so clearly marking where each end if block ends. And then this next line is part of the for each next loop. The for each line starts this loop and it repeats for every cell signified by myRange in the selected range. And the next myRange line means that we've finished with the current cell, so we can move on to the next one. And then once every cell is done, the loop stops. And we finally get to this part, application.screenUpdating, which turns screen updating back on so that Excel can show us the results. Pretty cool, right? Just 20 lines of code, and Excel now has a macro called Quick Clear that's like having a smart assistant to clear your data fast. But clearing numbers is only the start. VBA can do much more. Here's a simple app I built in Excel. It previews all the images in a folder. Then with just one click, it can rename hundreds of them based on the names that you choose. And the renaming doesn't stop at image files. It works just as well with CSV, PDF, or text files. This is the real power of VBA. It lets you build practical tools right inside Excel. You can automate reports, rename files, send emails, create dashboards, opening up a whole world of possibilities. Now, VBA won't solve every problem, but it can handle countless repetitive tasks, freeing up hours of your time. But here's the problem. Most people get excited about VBA, dive in, and then quit at the first hurdle. So here's the choice. If you're ready to stop guessing, stop copying random code, and truly master Excel VBA automation, check out my online course, Excel Macros and VBA School. It's got a 4.5 star rating on Trustpilot. And over 500 professionals have already transformed their Excel skills with this course. And you can be next. The link is in the description below. Or if you want to see more VBA in action, I've got the perfect video for you. It shows how I built my file renaming app with the help of AI to make it much easier. And the best part, you get the actual file to download so you can use it right away. Consider it a free addition to your Excel toolkit. What are you waiting for?